This is an explanation of how to use the spreadsheets that come with the textbook to calculate the equation of state properties, namely pressure, volume, and temperature. And so this is a very powerful spreadsheet. Let's go through the first tab, the PVT tab. So the idea is if we can put in, if we know the critical temperature, the critical pressure, and the eccentric factor, then we can determine at some temperature and pressure values of volume for liquid or vapor for two-phase systems. So the first thing we need to do, and we're going to do this for toluene, so we go to the tab that has the critical properties. On aromatics, we find toluene. So notice what it's listing. It's listing the critical temperature, the critical pressure, and then the eccentric factor. And these are formatted in the same way as appears on the other page that we started on. So if I select toluene and the three properties and copy and go back to the PVT tab and then paste here, then I've entered in the properties for toluene. So what I'm going to do, let's look at some cases where, well, let's look at the initial condition. Low temperature, high pressure, over 10 bar. It says it's only one root, and that root, you know, it's a low volume, a low compressibility factor, the kind of behavior we expect for a liquid. But let's look at maybe higher temperature, 350 Kelvin, and maybe 0.5 megapascals, which is 5 bar. So under those conditions, notice now we have three solutions. And those three solutions, so three solutions with different Z values and different volumes. So the large volume, of course, is the vapor phase. Small volume is the liquid phase. And then the in-between point is the physically unmeaningful solution to the cubic equation. However, only one of these values is physically the correct value, and that's the value with the lowest fugacity. So it calculates the fugacity. Notice the units are megapascals. What's going to be the stable state is the one with the lowest fugacity. So at 350 Kelvin, 0.5 megapascals, we're going to have a liquid phase for toluene, perhaps not too surprising at that kind of pressure. I'm familiar with toluene. So if we now, let's lower this to 1 atmosphere. So let's suppose we raise the temperature the other extreme first, 600 Kelvin. Notice we're in the one root region now. So there are no longer three solutions to the equation. Notice 600 Kelvin is above the critical temperature of 591.8, which means there can be only one solution to the equation. That's a fluid. Notice the compressibility factor is close to 1, so it really is behaving very similar to an ideal gas. If we go back to 350 Kelvin, we said this is a liquid. If we wanted to see where this toluene vaporized, let's raise the temperature 370 Kelvin. Still the lowest fugacity is for the liquid phase, so that's going to be the stable state. If we go to 400 Kelvin, however, now notice if we switch things, the lowest fugacity is for the vapor phase. So 0.097 is lower than 0.149, so we're going to be in the vapor phase. So we should be able to adjust this. 383. Just a wild guess. Notice now these fugacities are almost the same. The liquid one is slightly lower, so if I were to raise the temperature slightly more, 383.4, 9683, 9680, almost identical. So to a pretty good approximation, the boiling point, toluene, at 1 bar, a tenth of a megapascal, is 383.4 degrees Kelvin. The rest of the information on the spreadsheet is the intermediate values it uses to make the calculations and to solve the cubic equation. Another video then we'll look at the properties that can also calculate.